Hello and welcome. This reading is for my lovely Libras. Thank you for watching. And before we begin, let me go ahead and clear our energies and get into the reading. I welcome in my spirit guides and holy angels, nice and greatest good. I welcome messages of love and light that bring healing and love to you all. Please bless this reading. Thank you. All right, guys. So let's get into your reading and see what is the energy or vibe that we need to know in regards to the person that is connected to you in love. What is the energy or vibration of the person that is connected to you in love? What is the energy or vibration that is connected to you in love? Thank you, Spirit. All right. So we have sex. I'm not saying that sex is all I want, but I want your touch. And also, we have skepticism. Give me time to trust this connection. Also, we have secret admirer. I'm not ready to reveal my true feelings for you. And also, love story. A true love story never ends. Let's start a new chapter. Okay. So I have a feeling that there is a particular person that is under your radar and they're really skeptical about this relationship. You know, what I'm seeing here is that, you know, they're open for sexual relations with you, but they're not going to let you know that they secretly admire you. Okay. This person is very romantic in nature, but I have a feeling like they're a little bit reserved, possibly because, you know, maybe they were hurt in the past and they don't want to be completely transparent with their feelings or emotions. At least that is what I'm sensing here so far. So let's go ahead and see what else. Spirit, can you please reveal to me the energy of the person that is connected to Libras in love? What can you reveal to me about the person that is connected to Libra? All right. So, four messages for Libra. We have playfulness to recapture romance. Allow your inner youthful spirit of fun to shine. So they want to play, you know. I really feel like, you know, they're open for sex, open for playtime is what I'm getting. Is there anything else that we need to know about the person connected to Libra? Wow, we have a reconciliation. Someone from your past is returning to your life and getting to know each other. So this could be a past person that you already know. And what I'm getting here is that they want to get to know you on a deeper level. Okay, so I have a feeling like you guys may hook up anytime soon, right? But I really feel like they do admire you. They know that this is like some sort of like a fairy tale love story, or it's definitely something worth, you know, I guess writing about. Okay. At least that's what I'm saying. Also getting here, make the effort. Great love is worth taking the steps you're guided to take. And also pay attention to the red flags. The signs are cautioning you. So I have a feeling that this person really wants to make the effort, but they're very cautious. Okay, so they're treating this relationship like any other connection. Maybe they've burned one too many times in the past, and they're reluctant on making any kind of valid effort, right? So I do see that they want to get to know you and they want to play, but just know that there's more to the story, right? Like they really want to go deeper, and I mean that on a very intellectual level, not physical, but you know what I mean, because I definitely do see that that is on their mind. But yeah, I really feel like this person that generally wants to make the effort to get to know you. Okay. And also, if you've known this person before, Definitely a reconciliation. So let's go ahead and see what is going on with the tarot and see what else is going on with your person. So Spirit, can you please reveal to me the energy revolving around this person connected to Libra in love? What can you reveal to me about this person? How do they think of you? How do they feel? What do they want? And what is the outcome? What is the energy or vibration of the person that is connected to Libra? Let's see. Wow. So we have here Three of Cups. So there is a third party situation here. And I really am getting that your person is wanting to open up with their emotions. So, I mean, maybe there's other people involved. Like, let's say that your person has more than one option, but this person deeply has something there, okay, that they want to offer to you emotionally. Okay, so they're kind of like, you know, in between two different situations, and they're not happy. Maybe it's kind of like a codependent behavior, if you will, especially if it's sexual in nature, right? What I'm seeing here is that they're looking for change. So honestly, if your person was a player, okay, I don't know, I guess we can say it like that, or someone who was very attractive towards a lot of people, they're now looking for a commitment, okay? They're not looking for a hookup or, you know, someone to pass the time away on a very temporary basis. What I'm seeing here is that they're very defensive. So maybe your person is just too attractive that they just have to defend themselves. And they're like, you know what? Nope. You know, it's like they're just tired of having all of these options is what I'm getting. And they really wanted to give you an offer. And I know, right? You're like, to me, Libra? Yes, Libra. I'm seeing that, you know, maybe they were kind of cold or a bit standoffish towards you, but they're starting to see that they just weren't feeling very good, okay? So maybe on the outside surface, you know, things look okay with them. You know, they're attractive. A lot of people are gravitated towards your particular person here. But this person really wants to open up towards you. They just don't know if you're open for this, right? I see that, you know, maybe they've acted immature in the past and they were thinking about that. So I have a feeling like you've already been acquainted with this person and maybe, you know, they're just caught up in their own world, or they just had other people that was always surrounding them. And, you know, they're kind of thinking like, how could they open up towards Libra? Okay. Like, would you believe them is another thing I'm also hearing. Yeah, because I see here the Five of Swords and it's in reverse. So that just tells me that, you know, they could be conflicted. They could be in their head about the situation. And what I'm seeing here is that they're like kind of like looking at their options and they're kind of stuck. So why are they stuck? Because they want to move forward towards you. They're feeling this very passionate wanting to have like an encounter. Maybe it's like stiff, if you know what I mean. But they don't know, okay? So they really feel like maybe they shouldn't work on this, okay? But they really do. So it's like your person is tossing and turning. Maybe their, you know, their ideas on whether to pursue you or not is kind of like up in the air, because I really see it's like between you and someone else or something else. But it really feels like it's a group of people. I feel like your person is like maybe in the spotlight, or I don't know, maybe they're a public person. I'm getting also maybe they're an influencer. I mean, that could be for some. Or maybe, you know, someone political, or just kind of like, I don't know, surrounded by groups of people. Okay. So they really see that you are this empress. They want to be with you. They love you. Okay, they think you're beautiful or handsome. They definitely feel like you guys could be like a power couple. Okay. But they're kind of stuck. Okay. Again, this person is stuck between like a lifestyle. Okay. I don't know. You can take the lifestyle in many different contexts. Okay. If you know what I mean. But yeah, I mean, there's multiple people, groups of people. I keep getting that. They could be partying. Maybe they have like a visual to maintain. That's why they're gravitated towards a lot of people. A lot of people know of your person. And they really feel like they need to get out of, you know, just being so guarded. So that could mean like putting an end towards their lifestyle. So they can have a new opportunity with you. So, I mean, that's like a tall order, right? Especially if your person was kind of like in this kind of environment, if you will. You know, in 2023, I feel like your person wants to turn a new leaf and they want to put the past behind them so that they can move forward to love. Okay. Maybe for some, you're dealing with a Gemini. And before they were just emotionally unavailable, and now they want to do right by you. Okay. So this is your card. This is justice. So they want to make it right. Okay, so this person, I feel like by next year, wants to give you a solid offer, but they're not sure yet. Okay, so they're trying to figure it out so they can come back towards you. So again, this is a past person wanting to return back towards you because they realize that they had a hard time of letting this thing go. And what I'm seeing also is that they're not clear, you know, but they know that they love you, okay? You make them happy. They keep thinking about the past, okay? But there could have been a karmic situation that got in the way between the two of you. And it's unfinished business there. So they're accepting their loss of whatever has happened. And they want to move forward, okay? So I have a feeling like your person is ending a connection towards either a family, an investment, a job, something that they've spent a lot of time in. It's no longer serving them materially, okay, and energetically. So, very interesting. You know, your person's situation is definitely dealing with a third party, okay? So that's why your person admires you and they're really skeptical if, you know, you want to be with them is what I'm seeing here. But this person is very attracted to you. So they're thinking it's probably best if they hold themselves back and just wait maybe 3 weeks before they open up. I see that right now. They're just feeling at a loss. Okay, so they're kind of to themselves. You know, regardless of what you see and the physical, right? They just feel like, you know, isolated. Maybe they're not doing too well. It could be financial for some, but I just feel like they're holding themselves back on purpose and just waiting. It could be waiting until 2023. Okay, because I kept getting that also. I'm seeing here the Eight of Wands, the Four of Wands in reverse, and also the Six of Pentacles in reverse. So how they're feeling is that they want to communicate to you, okay, that, you know, things are not going well. They're not celebrating, you know, with those people. Okay, so you probably know who those people are. And also, you know, they just felt like they couldn't really work on it. So you may get like a confession or, you know, just this person wanting to talk to you about what has been going on. So this could be like, you know, the heart-to-heart conversation. You know, this person is making the effort. And also, you know, they want to open up and be playful with you, you know, for this sort of reconciliation. So they're setting the mood, right? So what is it that they want? They want to hold back because they're not in the best element. I feel like they're healing, okay? So they're feeling hopeless. They don't know, okay? So they're feeling kind of down and out. It could be the holiday blues, right? Because honestly, for your person to be very popular and, you know, just well-received and, You never know what the person's story is beneath the surface. They could look like the happiest person on earth, but deep down inside, there's more to the story, right? That's what I keep getting about your person. So maybe you know who this particular person is, Libra. You be the judge, right? Because I really feel like you know this person and you know that, you know, there's something that they're not revealing. Okay, so I could be talking about that one if this is resonating with you so far. So in the outcome, yeah, so they're not really being upfront and communicating to you. I see that, you know, they're just standing there to themselves. They just don't have the courage to open up as much as they do want to open up towards you is what I'm seeing here. And also they want to manifest a way to get over the past and heal so they can make a physical offer towards you. So again, I keep getting like this energy that next year, okay, 2023, if you guys have been in separation, this person will finally open up towards you. But I feel like your person is going through a period of healing. And honestly, around the holidays, they're not doing so great. Okay. Now, again, like this person may come to you with, you know, just sexual pleasures, you know, just, I don't know. It's just maybe that's what it was before in the past, but this person really wants to give you something more. Okay. Not just a hookup. They want a relationship. I have a feeling like your person's just tired of playing the field or just being open. Or maybe if they're in another commitment, they're just tired of that relationship and they're ready to settle down with you. Okay, so everyone's situation is different here. So that's what I have so far. So let's go ahead and see what is it that this person would like to confess. Spirit, what can you reveal to me about this person? What are the messages that want to come through for the person that is connected to Libras in love? Libra, what does your person want to say? Okay, what are the messages that want to come through? What does your person want to say towards you? Please bring forth the messages, Spirit, that Libra needs to hear about their love interest. Thank you. I love that you can see my truth, but it scares the shit out of me too. So Libra, it's like, how do you know, right? So I feel like you know your person more than anyone, and that's what they do admire about you. It's like, wow, you know, they're blown away is what I'm hearing. Sometimes I feel like it's not possible for you to care as much as you say that you do. Like it's not real and one day the truth will be revealed. I'm just staying prepared. So maybe this person thinks that you lie. Okay. Now, maybe that's what they're used to. I'm pretty sure that you're different, especially if you're watching my readings, because I mostly channel twin flame connections. And if you're a twin flame, then you already know that, you know, most twin flames do the healing work, the spiritual work, so that, you know, most of them, they do come correct. And, you know, and you learn from your past and then you grow from, you know, those negative experiences into positive experiences. So that's how they're feeling. But I really feel like that's a reflection of the karmic, okay, that they were with in the past. Okay, so there's a little bit of a mixing of past energy, you know, and projecting it onto you. Okay, let's see what else. I've pleasured myself thinking about you and the intimate times we shared. You have no idea how beautiful you are. So I really feel like this is where this comes in. I'm not saying that that is all that I want, but I want your touch. So this person has been thinking about you in intimate ways. But, you know, until they actually have physical intimacy, they don't know what they're in for, especially if you guys are twins. Because twin flame connections has that deep intimate connection that you guys have, and you guys would be doing a lot more exploring, not just the kink and fetish type situation, right? It's something deep and something that you possibly never felt before. So that's what I'm seeing there. Let's see. I sense your anger and resentment. I also mirror your fears. I need you to release these so that I can too and come back into your life. So maybe you were angry at them at some point. Maybe you resent them. Maybe it's because, I mean, honestly, I was getting like player vibes, or they were just open to other people, other situations. Maybe, you know, they're married. I mean, everyone's scenario is different here. But what I'm getting is that there was a group of people, a community, if you will. And this person really feels like they were a people pleaser, always wanting to please other people. And you're sitting here like, okay, well, what about me? You know, you're sitting here, you want to do everything with them, and you would, you know, go around town and the world if they really wanted that. But I really feel like they were doing this with whoever that was in their social group. Okay. So there must have been a situation in the past where you guys went into a sort of a separation, is what I'm getting. So let me go ahead and pick a final message. I'm really missing you lately. Nostalgia. So here we are. Your person misses you. They want to make the effort. They're really skeptical because of whatever has happened between the two of you. You know, they have more feelings than they're letting on, from what I can see. And if you guys just had like a sexual based connection, it's really more than that. Okay. It's just maybe this person is afraid of how you think. Okay, because they really don't know. And that's what I'm getting so far. So let's go ahead and see what is the guidance message that Spirit wants you to know at this time. What is the guidance message for Sun, Moon, Rising, or Venus, Libras? It says, how can I be more flexible right now? What are you trying to control? Maybe it's time to let go. Let love move through you today and trust the outcome will be for your highest good. Today's soul action, remind yourself all day long that you are safe, that life is happening for you, and that you are not alone. Then do some yoga. So maybe it's a time to be flexible and not be so rigid. I could be talking about your person, but I could be talking about you, because this person right here is sensing your anger and resentment. So you must have hated on them for something. But honestly, I mean, maybe you have valid reasons to do it, right? Maybe they went back to an ex and they said that they were going to spend time with you, or maybe they were giving you mixed signals and you're like, well, what the heck, you know? But again, that's why they're skeptical. If you would trust this connection, because maybe they flaked on you before in the past. At least that's the vibe that I'm getting. But I can really see that this person wants to make the effort. And by 2023, I really feel that you're going to see something different come from this individual. So I really hope that that was helpful. Let me know. Thank you all for watching. And if you guys would like to book a personal reading with me, you can visit www.scorpiomoonintuition.com. And you can also follow me on IG as Scorpio Moon Intuition. I hope y'all have a lovely day, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye.